have time to discuss.
Okay, I'll try to be not too boring. I know that I'm the last speaker. My presentation is about the use of electronic gnosis for the environmental odor monitoring. I'll try to explain a bit in deep what is an electronic nose and which are possible fields of application. In particular, I focus the attention on environmental odor monitorings, on how an environmental odor monitoring can be done by an electronic nose, and which are the drawbacks and the advantages of its adoption. An electronic nose is defined as an instrument which comprises an array of electronic chemical sensors with partial specificity and a pattern recognition system. This is an instrument capable of simulating the human olfaction. The electronic nose provides global characterization of an odor in terms of providing an olfactory fingerprint, and it is not able to provide a detailed characterization of the chemical composition of the odor's mixtures because sensors are not specific for different compounds. In order to involve an electronic nose, it is necessary to train the instrument, providing to the instrument a database of olfactory fingerprints related to the classes you want to consider during the monitorings or you want to discriminate in different applications. The electronic nose can be described as a sequence of three systems, which are the sample delivery systems, the detection system, and the data processing and pattern recognition unit. The sample delivery system is the system which sample delivery system, we refer to the systems used for analyzing the odorous mixtures. You can have different type of electronic gnosis and different type of delivery systems depending on the application you want to consider. For the environmental odor monitoring, you have usually a tube connected with a dedicated pump which sucks the air into the detection system, which is the heart of the electronic nose. While for other type of application, you need to think about different systems for creating the gaseous headspace and analysis. The heart of the electronic nose is the detection system, which is constituted by the sensor array. The nature of the sensor array may be composed by different type of sensors, which are partially selective to the compounds of interest. The features of the sensor should be fast, stable, and should provide reproducible responses responsible over time. The most important feature is that the sensors respond to the presence of the VOC compounds with changes of their chemical or physical properties. These variations in chemical and physical properties are recorded as a signal and are elaborated in order to create the olfactory fingerprint related to the mixture analyzed. This process must to be reversible in order to use a sensor many times and not only once
only once.
The electronic nose may be equipped with different with more than one sensors, and the number and the type of sensor to be involved depends on the type of application of the electronic nose. The electronic sensors are differentiated according to the type of the chemical or physical properties that is simulated by the presence of the VOC. The most common types are the conductivity sensors, among which the metal oxide semiconductors and the conducting polymers, and the piezoelectric sensors like the quartz crystal microbalances. The last part of the electronic nose is the data processing and the pattern recognition unit. We can describe the process of the data processing as the sequence of three aspects, which are the feature extraction, the exploratory analysis, and the pattern recognition. During the analysis with an electronic nose consists in the in recording every fixed interval of time the response of sensors. This in case of most sensors, the resistance variation is recorded as signal. In order to create the olfactory fingerprint, it is necessary to translate this information in a mathematical form in order to create data for the successive statistical elaborations. This aspect is the feature is known as feature extraction, and it consists in the extraction from the curve of particular characteristics such as the resistance ratio between the value recorded at the beginning of the measure and after the analysis of the odorous mixtures or other parameters. All this data represents the data set relevant to the analysis of different compounds, and it is n-dimensional. In order to reduce, since sensors are may provide redundant information, it is you perform an exploratory analysis in order to reduce the dimensionality of the dataset. The most common technique is the principal component analysis, and since this technique does not consider the label of the of samples, it provides also an idea of the discrimination between the different olfactory classes you have considered. In the end, after the training set has been created, the pattern recognition system provides an estimation of the classification of the unknown compounds. In particular, all those algorithms are based on the principle that the distance between two points in the dataset is inversely proportional to their similarities. Therefore, points the software estimates the class of the unknown compounds according to the main classes of their of its neighbors. The electronic nose can be involved in many different kinds of application. The most common is the environmental one, but you can use it for food quality control, for the early detection of different diseases, and for example, indoor air quality. During this presentation, I will explain more in detail the environmental odor monitoring. The electronic nodes are able to perform a direct characterization of the odor impact related to specific industrial activities, because these instruments are capable of performing of continuously analyze ambient air at low cost, and they are able to provide fast responses. The instruments for the environmental odor monitoring should be specifically developed, because the outdoor use entails peculiar aspects, such as the problems related to atmospheric condition variabilities, variation in humidity and temperature, and sensors are usually very, very sensitive also to these to the variation of these parameters. The crucial aspect of the adoption of an electronic nose is the training. The training consists in the in providing to the instrument the data set relevant to the olfactory classes you want to monitor. This data set will be used during the monitoring in order to provide an estimation of the odor presence and for a qualitative characterization of the odor which is detected. In order to estimate the odor impact related to a specific industrial activity, it is necessary to train the instrument towards the main emissions related to that activities. Samples of these classes are taken directly at plant emissions and are presented to the instrument at different concentration. This data creates the training model. The odor impact is assessed considering the installing the trained electronic nose at suitable receptors that can be the house of the woman who lamented odor presence, or in some cases also the fence line of the industrial activity you want to monitor. The odor impact is estimated considering the time percentage which during which the instrument has perceived the odor presence during the monitoring interval. Usually we refer to, since a European standard about the electronic nose has not yet been published, we refer to the German guidelines in order to establish some limits about the odor presence. These guidelines establish the limit of accessibility of odor hours per year that can be perceived in territories surrounding the plant at 10% for residential areas and at 50% for industrial areas. Now I will explain, I will present a monitoring that we implemented for an Italian landfill. We involved two different electronic noses, and we decided to install one electronic nose at the fence line and the other at the receptor downwind, after having evaluating the meteorological condition, the most common meteorological condition of the area.
Different but the same type.
Yes, the same type of two identical instruments. The as a first thing, we trained the instrument to the main emissions of a landfill. So we trained towards the landfill gas from the extraction wells, the fresh waste on the surface of fresh waste conferred to the landfill, the leachate and the LFG combustion gases.
LFG stands for landfill gas.
Landfill gases. This year I reported a PCA score plot in order to make a bit clear what I intended with the reduction of dimensionality of the dataset relevant for training. In particular, here you can see that there are different points relative to the different classes we have considered for the training, and the PCA score plot shows a good discrimination between different olfactory classes. Then we install the instrument at the fence line and at the receptors, and we evaluated the odor impact considering the percentage of time during which the instrument perceived the odor presence. In this case, at the receptor, for example, the odor from the landfill were detected for about 6.3% of the total duration of the monitoring, and the main odor source was identified to be the landfill gas. In the odor monitoring by an electronic nose allowed an effective and direct characterization of the odor impact without requiring a detailed characterization of the emissions. In this sense, we can use the electronic nose as an alternative of the dispersion model when the emissions to be considered are discontinuous, or when they are very difficult to be modeled. The electronic nose has an advantage, a positive effect on the population, which is comforted by the presence of an instrument that continuously characterizes the ambient air. And in the case of the presence of main different industrial activities in the same territories, with a good training set, it is possible to obtain also the from the electronic nose the indication of the emission responsible for the odor annoyance. As a drawback, the odor impact based on the quantification of the frequencies is only based on the consideration of the frequency of the odor presence and not by their intensity. And as Marzio said before, the intensity should be considered also as a parameter, because a strong odor may be bad than a moderate one. The instrument.
There's a very interesting research by Zucker mm-hmm. that actually shows that intensity is not the best. I don't think this is a drawback, actually, I think it's an advantage. Mm-hmm. Because this investigation shows that intensity is actually not the main thing for citizen complaints. It's the
frequency.
Okay.
So I wouldn't put that as a drawback, I would put it in the other.
Okay.
Another a drawback is the absence of a specific regulation and also the instrument complexity, because by now the instrument can be used only by expert people. According to, in 2016, the European Committee has constituted a specific group for the definition of a standard regulation in order to solve the problem of lack of norm or standardization about electronic nose. This group is working on the standardization of performance requirements to call an instrument an instrument for odor for continuous odor monitoring, and on the definition of an experimental procedure to the performance verification and validation. Thank you for listening.
So, with this was the last presentation for today. I hope you enjoyed this training on
not basic,
odor pollution.
Not
okay,
from
not
my
unit. This is good.